Hello everyone, welcome to today's video. My name is Wesley Walker. I am a data analytics manager and previous SEO executive. And in today's video, I'm going to be talking you through how to use Google Trends to grow your YouTube channel. So the previous video I did, which was one of my first videos, seemed to get quite a lot of support, and there were quite a lot of people asking, well, there were a few people asking if I could do a little bit more in depth into how to use Google Trends, because I talked about it quite a bit. So this is what this whole video is going to be about. I'm going to be talking through Google Trends, how I use it, and how you can use it yourselves to grow your YouTube channel and potentially your website as well. So as we can see here, I'm currently on the Google Trends interface. So what Google Trends is essentially Google provides information and data on search terms, and it shows you how these specific search terms or search topics are trending over time. So it gives you a good gauge of how searches on the web, YouTube image, web search are trending. And the really great thing about it is that you can really dig deep into the trends. So you can see it on a weekly, daily, even an hourly basis, which is really, really useful, especially if you want to do reactive content. So what I'm going to do, for example, I'm going to search in something that I tend to look up quite a lot. So we'll look up anime reaction, for example, and we'll look at the past 12 months. So immediately we're given the trend for this specific search term. So we can see that over the past 12 months, we've seen a gradual increase for anime reactions. So by default, Google Trends will always put you through to web search. But if you're interested in YouTube search, you can click this filter here, and I'll show you all the different types of searches that are made through Google's interface. And of course, because Google owns YouTube, YouTube search pulls into Google Trends as well, which is where it becomes really, really powerful for YouTube content creators. So change to YouTube search, and you can see the trend for United States. If you're YouTube, if you're a YouTuber, you want to see this at a worldwide view, just because your videos will be pushed not just to the US or to the UK, it'll be pushed globally. So we can see the trend over time. So now we can see that this seems to be quite a popular keyword phrase. There seems to be a lot of consistent volume here. And when you scroll down further, you can see more insights here that are provided by Google Trends. So we can see, first of all, the interest by region. So we can see that in Japan, is the most popular region for the specific search term, anime reaction, and second is Singapore. So how to understand these numbers here is that, and how to understand Google Trends in general, is that you'll get a score which will be based on the peak popularity. So what we can see right here is that between the 26th of July and the 1st of August, we had an interest score of 100, and that means at that point it was a peak popularity. And then when you look at 16th to 22nd of August, we get a score of 73, and this means that that period was 73% as popular as it was at its peak. So that's a good way to read the scores and the measures. So it's just essentially, this is 100% peak, that's 73%, 76% peak essentially. So now this is where we can get into like the really good stuff here. So what we can start looking to is the related queries. So we can see some of the keywords that are breaking out and that have been trending over the past 12 months that are similar to what we've searched in here. So we can see anime fire songs, for example, is breaking out. So how this is measured, it will show a percentage change, or it will show breakout. So if breakout, I believe breakout is there if it doesn't have any previous data. So if there's no previous comparison, you can't really do percentage change. So it says breakout, which means it's really, really, it's a brand new but also a really, really popular keyword phrase. And then beyond that, you'll see the percentage changes. So, and it's typically weighted by the most popular keywords. So the first one, anime fire song. So this one's breaking out at the moment, a very popular keyword. And you can see the list goes on, and you can scroll across and you can see all the other related keywords. There's actually another way to look at the related query. So by default, you look at the rising. So these are the trending searches. But you can look at just the most popular as well, so just the top keywords that are most searched the most, not just the trending keywords. And then you can see you get quite a different view. So we get here anime OP, anime opening. There's a lot of volumes around anime openings. I know that from firsthand. Reaction anime reaction mashup, for example. And again, this gives you an actual score. So we see the anime OP is the most popular search term with a score 100. and anime opening score of 98, so almost as popular. Makes it opening, and you can see the score gradually gets lower and lower as we go down. You can also see topics and related topics, and I'll get into that in a second, because topics are another way that you can actually segment and look into the Google Trends data. So say for example, if you want to look at a specific topic, anything that you might want to base your entire channel over, you can change that and you can look at that specific topic. So if we search in here, search engine optimization, so what we will be doing now is we'll be looking at an entire topic of keywords. So this would be a cluster of keywords that Google have identified as being relevant to each other. So we're looking at SEO as a whole, not just SEO, that specific search engine query in YouTube. So we can see the trend over time, quite a big volume keyword. We see that between the 7th and the 13th of June this year, SEO was search engine optimization. The topic itself was most popular then. We can then see the interest by region, and then we can see all the related queries within the topic. And again, you can segment this by top as well. So we can see SEO, very big keyword, how to SEO, not as big, SEO YouTube, SEO tutorial, SEO 2020, etc. So you get to see it all. You can also compare keywords. So if you wanted to see what keywords, topics, or specific keywords themselves are more popular, you can do that all within here. So for example, if we compared SEO to search engine marketing, so then we can clearly see that search engine optimization is searched far more on YouTube than it is for search engine marketing. Again, you can see the average score is 83 for SEO and about 10 for search engine optimization. And again, the way you should read this chart is that when search engine optimization was at its peak between the 7th and the 13th of June and we had a score of 100, search engine marketing only had about 9% of the volume at its peak for that day. So that's a good way to read this data. And again, once you've put in the two topics, you can again go through the keywords, the related queries, and the top queries for both of them as well. So if we look at search engine marketing, we can see SEM is a top keyword, and we see a couple others that pull through as well. What you can also see is that sometimes you might see a few random keywords that pull in, which might not be too relevant for whatever you're doing research for. So you'll probably want to use the categories filter. So what, there are loads of categories in here that Google have defined themselves. And this can be really good to help you like further segment and deep down into just the specific queries that you want. So for example, we're looking at specifically just marketing focus keywords. So we're going to try and use business and industrial. It's the marketing in here, advertising and marketing. And then when we scroll down, it's the queries have now been refined to simply just that. For SEO, you can see SEO 2020, but you can also see a couple of queries that aren't in English. And again, that's because we've got it filtered to worldwide. So if you wanted to look at just the UK, for example, we can do that. But then again, search engine marketing isn't really searched within the UK on YouTube. The topic itself has a very small volume within this category as well. So sometimes you just got to bear in mind that if you're segmenting down that much plus a nation, so if you look at a specific country and you apply a lot of filters, you will struggle to get data. So just bear that in mind. So this information is pretty good if you want to look at a broader view of long form content, long lasting, long life content to create on your channel. But if you want to look at things that are trending right now, things that people are searching for right now, then a good way to go at this is to actually filter the results and look at for the last 7 days or 30 days. So I typically tend to go for the last 7 days because that's proven quite well for me. And because you'll practically see any trends happening within real time as long as you keep checking the results in Google Trends. So we're going to change this view. We're going to remove our filters. Go back to worldwide and look at the past 7 days. So this will show us what people have actually been searching to do with SEO, search engine optimization within the past 7 days. And so we can see And when we get into this level of detail, we actually can now get an hourly view rather than the daily view or the weekly view that we had before, which is really, really helpful, especially if you're trying to make really reactive content. And what this tells you is that we can see roughly when such an optimization tends to peak at the time of day. So we can see that generally tends to be a lot of interest for SEO in the early hours in the morning, so about 7 to 9 a.m. seems to be a pretty good time to post anything, or because that tends to be the time when people are most searching for these queries in the last 7 days. You can also get this view for specific keywords as well. So say, for example, if we were to look at a new show which is trending now, Attack on Titan Reaction, we can see that on this day, the 6th of December, we see this was the day that the new episode for this series arrived. And you can see on that day, there was a huge spike in demand for people actually looking for YouTubers' reaction to them. So this is what you would call researching into for reactive content. So if you're looking for what people are actively searching for right now, something new, something trending, you can see this view quite clearly by looking at the last 7 days. So if you're interested in specific keywords such as Attack on Titan and you're thinking about making videos about it, by leveraging this information, you can see when people are beginning to search for it and get a little bit of a gauge of what the demand is and what it's like. So once you've done your research using Google Trends, whether it be looking for more long-lasting, long-form content, or if you're looking for like short-term trend reactive content, Google Trends is a perfect tool for that. Once you've identified your queries, understand where the market is, what the search volume is like, you can then record your videos, create them, post them on YouTube, and track your rankings. And a tool that I recommend, which I used in the past, was vidIQ. It's very easy, free Chrome extension, which shows you where you rank for the specific keywords that you have used in your video tags. So in summary, how you can use Google Trends to grow your YouTube channel is by doing the research, so searching up your topics or your specific keywords, finding out trending or popular keywords that are being searched by your target audience, creating videos based on those topics or based on that specific keyword, and then posting on YouTube using the keywords that you found in Google Trends in your video tags, and then tracking the performance through a tool like vidIQ to see where you're ranking. Also, I recommend not just using Google Trends for YouTube SEO purposes. You should always use your YouTube analytics data as well. So YouTube analytics has improved a lot in the past few years, especially with the keyword data and the impressions and the marketing, really the marketing data that they give you has improved quite a lot. So doing your research with Google Trends is one first great step, but then after a day or so, just check your reach statistics and have a look at what keywords people were searching for when they found your video, and if there are any that are providing a lot of volume that you missed out in your tags, or you haven't optimized your description for your title, then just re-optimize accordingly and look at the results. So that's my video for how to use Google Trends to improve your YouTube channel. If you guys found this useful, please share it around with other YouTubers or other people you know who may find it useful. Please subscribe for more videos on SEO, digital marketing, and analytics. And if you found this video helpful, please give us a thumbs up because it really helps me out. Till the next video.